enjoy doing magic shows. And to stay healthy, I'm taking Tai Chi and renewing my studies with my teacher from 40 years ago. And in order to keep my mind sharp, every day I practice memorizing a shuffled deck of cards. Now this evening I'd like to try this, and I've only done it a few times, but I'd like to try and memorize a shuffled deck of cards for you this evening. Now, if I shuffled it, well, you may not trust me. So we're going to let you shuffle the cards before we do this. And you can mix them in any way that you'd like. Are there some people here that are good at card shuffling? Would you mix those up? And would you mix those up? And are you good at card shuffling? How about you?
Oh,
cards. Yeah, you can mix those up. How about you, Ken? Can you mix those up? Mix them up. Shuffle them. We're not judging you in any way. Just mix them up. And now, if you would give your cards to her, I want you to mix those all together. That's okay.
Don't worry.
Sudden gust of gravity rush through here. That's fine and dandy. I want you to mix those up. And would you pass your cards to Ken and have Ken mix those all up? Mix them all up. Shuffle them up. Ken's a pretty good shuffler there. All right. You've mixed up your cards, and they're just totally random there. Yes, indeed. All right. I think those are thoroughly mixed, don't you? Wonderful. Yes, indeed. And you mixed yours. So now, here's what I figured out in order to speed things up here a little bit. I don't have to remember the whole deck. All I have to do is remember half of it. And if I know what's in half, I know that it's not in the other half. So I'm going to attempt here now to memorize half of the deck. Does anybody here have a second hand on their watch or on their phone? Yours does? Has a second hand?
Yeah.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, here's what I want you to do. I'm going to ask you to say go, and I'm going to start. Then I'll tell you stop. And you tell me what time it is, how many seconds you can use that. So you say go, and I'll go, I'll tell you to stop. You say go. Stop.
13 seconds.
13 seconds, if I got this, this is a Guinness World Record. You see, I only had to look at half the cards. If I know what's in this half, I know that they're not in this half. So, Ken, would you take all those? And would you take all these? And what I want you to do now is separate them into suits. I want all the clubs together, all the hearts together. They don't have to be in order, all the diamonds and all the spades. Now I'm going to explain to you how this works. When you try to remember things, it's very, very difficult. When you try to think of things, sometimes it doesn't come to mind because numbers are abstract. We all have trouble remembering things. So in order to remember things, you have to have a picture. You make a picture, an image, a visual thing. And the more outrageous it is, the easier it is to remember. For instance, if I wanted to remember the Three of Hearts, the easiest way for me is to picture a tree with hearts on it. And that's the Tree of Hearts. So you have a little joke there, and you have a visual thing that you're going to remember. The same is true with the clubs. I imagine a club hitting somebody with a club. A diamond, I imagine diamonds are a girl's best friend. A spade, I imagine a shot. So Ken, you've got yours all separated like that, right? And have you got them into suits over here yet, Amanda?
Not quite.
Okay, that's fine. And
can I not have them face up?
No, I don't want to see them. I don't want to see, because I'm going to tell you what's in your hand in just a minute. So I don't want to see what's in your hand. So you want to put those all together so I don't see what you have there? You got them all in different suits. Okay, that's very good. I'll just grab them.
Bathroom mirror.
Okay, you got clubs, you got hearts, you got diamonds, you got spades. All right, here's them all separated out there. That's okay. All right, now you can sit right where you are, but hold the cards so that they're facing you. Right, so that you can see them. And I'm going to tell you what each of you has in your hands. So let's start with clubs. Here, I imagine a club. And Amanda, you have the clubs over there? And you don't have to have them in order, but you have the ace of clubs. Is that right? Now, if I tell you the right thing, what I want you to do is just take the ace of clubs out, or whatever card I name, and just drop it on the ground in front of you. Just take it right out and drop it on the floor. That way we'll know that I got that one. Ace of clubs.
That's big.
Oh my gosh.
Sorry.
Now, the puppy paw.
This one?
Yeah.
The puppy paw. He's in there.
Sorry.
That's okay. That's okay. So you got all the clubs there, Amanda? Because we're going to come back to you in just a minute. Ken, you have the two and the three of clubs. Is that right? Take them out and drop them on the floor. Is that right? That go three? Okay. And Amanda, I'm not done with you. You have the four of clubs. And you have the five of clubs. And you have the six of clubs. Is that right?
Yes.
Ken, you have the seven. Amanda, you have the eight and nine. Ken, you have the 10, and the jack, and the queen, and that would mean the king is over there with you. And now let's look at the hearts, and when I see hearts, I see the cupid, and she's shooting this arrow, she's shooting the arrow. And so I know that Ken has the ace of hearts, and he has the two of hearts also, and Amanda has the three of hearts, and the four of hearts. Five. You have a six also. You know? Ken, you got the six. And you got the seven. You have the seven and the eight. Ken, you have the nine and the ten and the jam. And Amanda, you have the queen. And Ken, you have the king. So that's all of those. Almost got it all. I don't know if that ruins my Guinness record. Here we go. Let's try with spades.
We want our money back.
Yeah, we want it. Guinness does too. We'll go get a Guinness afterwards. That'll be even better. Two fools, huh? All right, so we're at spades. Amanda, you have the ace of spades. You have the two of spades, and you have the three of spades. Kim, you have the four of spades. Amanda, you have the five of spades, and the six of spades. Ken, you have the seven. You have the eight. You have the nine. Amanda, you have the ten. Ken, you have the queen. No, jack, I'm sorry. And queen. And then the king would be over here. Is that right? Yeah, excellent. So now we're just down to the diamonds. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. We're going to go real fast here. Ken, you have the ace of diamonds. You have the two of diamonds. You have the three of diamonds. You have the four of diamonds. Amanda, you have the five. Ken, you have the six and the seven. Amanda, you have the eight, nine, ten. You have the joker, and that's your last card. That means that she has the queen, the king, and the joker. You have the jack. Is that right? That's all of them. You have the joker. That's all of them. There it is. All right. Thank you very much. Thank you. It has been my pleasure to have you here this evening. I really enjoyed it. I hope you did too. In fact, if you had half the fun I've had, then I had twice the fun you've had.